This conference will now be recorded.
Any questions, guys? Suma, Prapurna. No questions. Okay. So let's continue with our discussion. We were talking about partitioners in the last session, right? So any doubts about partitioner in the last what we were discussing? Any doubts about partitioner? Can anyone tell me what is a partitioner?
Can we discuss this partitioner again?
No, we'll discuss in detail. I'll show you that how to code and all. But what do you guys understand the partitioner in, you know, with respect to?
It's an abstract class. It doesn't have a proper implementation definition. Just like we have abstract classes, we use it to extend. I mean, it is for hash partitioning. We use it as to extend it.
Okay. What is a hash code partitioner? Hash partitioner? What is a hash partitioner?
Just like we had the hash partitioning in our map transformations, MapReduce. So likewise, we have in our in Spark as well, wherein the keys are divided by a particular not divided but taken modulo by some number, and then the basis on the on that it is the keys are put into respective partitions.
Okay, let me explain with an example. Partition is different and partitioner is different. Try to remember the difference. Partitions are something like how the when you load the data, how the partitions will be divided. But partitioner will help us to which key has to go to which partition. When you are doing a key by key operations, which key has to go to which partition, it will be decided by the partitioner. Okay. So there are two type of partitions. Partitioners, I mean to say. So one is a hash partitioner, other one is a range partitioner. So we have seen yesterday the base introduction. Let's see in detail today. Okay, I'm going to make use the default what it called like a word count program. So the word count program, we have a reduce by key, right? So I'll be passing reduce by key based on my own partition algorithm. Okay, so let's see that. Let me take a same old count program. Don't mind, I'm copying the same thing because we already discussed all about this. So I'm going to copy all of them. I'll remove unnecessary stuff. Okay, from this let me take out the necessary stuff because I have already explained all these things. Okay, I don't want to do this one. Even this is also not required. This is just to print on the console how it is divided, one comma one other stuff. Otherwise let it be, no problem. Okay, so here if you observe closely, this is, we read the data, we created a base RDD, then we just check in the number of partitions, we did the flat map, and we split it by the columns, split it by the space. Okay, the lines has been split into words. Then here it is just printing in the console what are the words. Then here we are created word comma one pair. So I have already told why we are creating like this. If I have a word comma one, it will be easy for me in the next level. Easily I can aggregate it. And this is how aggregation will happen. This is how that calculation happened. If you observe closely, this is map and these are all narrow transformations. And this is the wider transformation. Here actually the make sure that how the data will be split by key into different partitions. Okay, here I'm planning to set to this is a text file, right? I'm planning to set by default three partitions. I don't want to take eight partitions. Okay, by default it comes two partitions, right? Because it's a small file. I'm going to do three partitions. By default it will come two partitions. I'm going to split into three partitions. Okay, let me check that as well. I'm going to run this program to see how many partitions it has been created. Some issue happened. This is output. Okay, output saying this all the output directory already exists. But anyway, we are not interested in that part. These are the votes. Number of partitions, three. Because we have set explicitly three partitions. Okay, now let me do one thing. I'll execute line by line in the console to make you understand what is happening in the line by line. First I'm reading the RD file with the three partitions. You can see that how many partitions has been created. It will show three partitions because while reading itself, I have specified three partitions. And I have splitted the data. After splitting, I'm just printing those information in the console. I have splitted here. I'm printing the data in the console. This is what to happen. The words has been splitted. The lines by initially it will be lines. The lines has been splitted by space and the words has been created. Once the words is created, I'm going to apply the map transformation to create a word comma one pair. I'm going to execute to create word comma pair, word comma one pair. So this is word comma one pair. The RDD2 is completely words. That words I'm taking, I'm just attaching every word one, the number one I'm attaching for the next level of aggregation. This is the one. Okay. So far, if you see that number of partitions and all, let me show you that. RDD3. Dot get num partitions, three partitions. Okay, so for the partitions are three partitions. Then now I'm going to execute reduce by key. I'm going to execute reduce by key. Okay, let's see what happens here. It is reduces key wise. Okay, and before I print it, the console, just say this is also showing three partitions. If you go to the console, if you go to this Spark UI, after for each or after reduce by key, we don't execute any action. Let me execute this action. Counts. Okay, now I got the counts. This is recent for each. Click on this. Click on this dark visualization. I told you, right? These are all the narrow transformations, and reduce by key is a wider transformation. Okay, that's the reason it's created different stage. Others are different stages, and this is different stage. Okay, here actually the data shuffle is happened. Here, if you see that shuffle RDD, here the data shuffle is happened. Okay, so the data has been shuffled across the different partitions. Since we are working on the local runner mode, you may not be able to see you will be able to see the close to real time, but no, these are all like it will always shows that here. Let me go back one step. If you see the locality level, as of now it is any it's like period, so what I can say, like it is running on the local mode, so the data is actually there in the local only. It is not there in the somewhere else. If you see in the different machines, it will, the locality level will be vary, okay, based on the data resides, rack locality, process locality, local. There are different options will be shown, so we'll see that later. Now before here it is happen the shuffling, right? So this shuffling happen in this manner, and let me write into the output file and we will see what are the keys are going into which partition. Then I will apply the our hash partition and we'll see how it will go. Okay, let me write into 18, some location 18, sorry. Are you guys following me? Does anyone has any doubts? It's a simple program as we already discussed this one. These are the three part files. Let's open these three part files. In part 000, you have this combination. I mean, these keys. You have these keys. In partition 1, you have these keys. And partition 2, you have these keys. Now, I'm going to apply before reduce by key. I'm going to apply my own partition algorithm. My own partition algorithm. That is hash code partition, hash partition. So for that, let me because we are going to use a hash partition, we need to import the hash partition because by default your console or Sparksell will not be knowing it. So we need to import the partitioner, which partitioner I'm going to use. So for that, import warg dot apache dot spark dot hash partition. It's a class, so it will start with a capital letter. Hash partitioner. Now let's see. I see here before reduce by key, I will apply my own partition algorithm. So before RDD3, so RDD3 only we have a pairs. RDD3 only we have a pairs. So on top of the RDD3, I'm going to apply this. Well, my party. My partitioner actually, okay, my party rdd equal to rdd3 dot here rdd3 dot partitioner or partition by, okay, partition by. Let's see, you have a option partition by. I'm specifying my own partition, my partition by here. We will pass object of hash partitioner. We'll pass our object of hash partitioner. New hash. About is it no partitioner. Partitioner. I'm going to specify here. If you guys remember yesterday, I have clearly say that the partitioner. If you go and see the hash partition. If you go and see hash partitioner, it is taking what? How many partitions you want? How many partitions you want? This is what we have seen yesterday, right? So we need to pass the number of partitions. So let's assume that this time I'm passing 3 only. Okay, next time I'll pass 4 and I'll show you. This time I'm passing 3 only. Okay, I created my own partition algorithm. I mean, I'm passing my hash partitioner algorithm. Now let's go ahead and see how this reduce by key works. Instead of RDD3, we need to give my partition RDD3. Yes, if anyone is not able to follow, please ask me. I'll stop and I'll try to explain you. Okay. Now write into file. We have written into 18, right? Now we'll write into 19 or something. Right. It's done. Now also it is divided into three partitions. Partition 0, you got the combination virtual accumulating and all. Here also you got the similar kind of thing. Is there anything it changed? Long, small, EC2. It looks somewhere. It's, yeah, here it is instances, then the resources. It line number 18 and 19, 20, 21, we'll see. This is actually instances, then D came, then resources came. Okay. But if you see closely, there is no huge difference. I mean, there is no difference. Ideally, there is no difference. Okay. It means by default, your Spark is using hash partition algorithm. By default, it is using hash partition algorithm. Now, if we use our own another partition algorithm, suppose if you have written your own partition class and your one second. So if you write your own partition algorithm, like your custom partition class, and you can specify that. Let's take an example in word count only, which I used to do in MapReduce. Whichever the letters start with the A has to go into one partition. Whichever the letters start with B, they have to go to another partition. C, another partition. D, another partition. Like that, we can divide the data. For that, what we need to do, we have to write our own partitioner algorithm code. We have to write our own partitioner algorithm code. How we will write that, how it is possible, can we write it or not? So we can write it. I have already written that into MapReduce code, but here also similar code. There is no difference, right? Here also similar code. So let me show you how we can write our own partitioner algorithm. It looks every time we need to search for it. There is something called MapReduce demo. SMR demo or something, MapReduce demo. Look at here. This is one partition. This is different partition. This is a gender base. Okay. This is gender based partition. All male will go into one partition. All female will go into one partition. This is another example. I have another example. This is the one. Okay. Look at here. I have written my own partition algorithm. Same here also, we need to write a similar kind of same kind of example only. But here we pass the key comma value, but here we'll not pass the key comma value, we'll pass only what I can say, like number of partitions. Okay, so let me try. In Spark, I didn't try writing my own partition. Let's try writing our own partition. Before that, let's view. Let me close others by demo. Partition, you need partitions. Good. So you don't need the value. And how is getting key here? Okay, let me write my own partition algorithm here. My partitioner. It's a class only. It should extend partitioner. This partitioner. It actually expecting an argument. What is that argument? What is that argument? What is that argument?
Words. Words.
No.
Keys, that is.
Okay. No. Partitions.
Partitions.
Partitions. Number of partitions. I have shown you here. No. While I'm creating my partition, what I have passed. Partitions. Okay. So we need to pass. Partitions. You can say you can name it as something different. Where is this? My partitioner. Okay. And a partitioner is what? It's an abstract, and it has abstract methods. What I need to do here? It's not coming the option. We need to write. We can just do. There is a shortcut. I'm just looking for that. It'll says that it'll implement unimplemented methods or something like that. 1 second. Implement methods. Okay. See, your partitioner class is abstract class, correct? What is the what I can say? If you are extending an abstract class, if that abstract class has any unimplemented methods, when we say unimplemented methods, those are called abstract methods. Yes or no, guys? I think I don't know how many of you remember. It has been quite a long time. If you have any unimplement methods or abstract methods, those methods has to provide the. We have to provide the implementation. Otherwise, your class also has to be declared as abstract. You guys remember this point? I don't know how many of you remember. Either abstract or trait. If you are using trait or abstract, if you are extending abstract class, any of the abstract class has abstract methods, those methods must be implemented in the child class. Actually, it is our child class only. No, where is that? My partition. This is my child class only. No, this is the parent and this is the child. You have to write in the child class. Are you guys following? That is how you see your hash partition overridden these two parts. It means if you are extending any trait or abstract classes, you have to provide a body for abstract
methods.
Yeah, good. Let's move on. So here I'll just go partitions only, number of partitions. I'm going to assign the partitions. So nothing else. Here the implementation vary. Here I need to change the implementation. Okay. Here the implementation, what actually I do, I'll copy the same implementation. I'll take this. Logic is same. Okay. That's the reason I'm taking it. Instead of any, let's check once. Okay. Let's return int. Clipboard contains seems to be Java. Do you want to convert to Scala code? Okay, let's try. Wow, beautiful. Beautiful, it's converted automatically. Okay, very simple. Look at here, guys. Key, I have a key. What is the key here in this case? What is the keys in this case? Words. The words. These words. Workload, govern per unlimited desktops, these words. Okay, these words will be keys here. We're converting into two string because here it is any data type is any. We're converting into two string. That string I'm taking, converting into lowercase. Everything I'm considering as a lowercase character at position zero, zeroth position I'm taking. So when I take the zeroth position, what will happen? First character will come in the word. That word minus A. When I do minus A, this is minus operation. Here, we need to understand what happening. Here, what is happening here is, if you have a character, minus if you do another character, it will return you, ASCII code of that character. Let me show you. V minus it returns you the ASCII code of V. What is the ASCII code of V? Even I didn't remember. I will check it. Okay. I think we can print in the console also.
A65, the ASCII value of A65.
I'll just see ASCII table. It's a small A, capital A 65, that's correct. It's a small A, it's a 97, and V, small V is 118 minus 97. 118 minus 97. 118 minus 97. So 21. Okay, that is the what happened. In this my program also, I'm taking the first character of the word minus A I'm doing. Then I'll get the ASCII. If my ASCII is less than 26 and greater than 0, greater than or equal to 0, then I'm returning that. Else return 0. Okay. What is the meaning of this cells written 0? Any special characters comes, I'm putting into 0th partition only. If your range is not less than, see, all alphabets are 26 only. If you do minus on this, you'll get the 26 only. If you want, I can prove here. You can take a Z here, Z, Z, minus A, you'll get 25. Okay, obviously between 0 to 25 only. Obviously it will be between 0 to 25 only. 0 to 25. So when you have a 0 to 25, if it comes different ASCII, it means there's a different character. If I'm getting something apart from 0 to 25, if I'm getting anything else, that means it's a special character. Okay. But here, let me see the number of partitions. I'm taking this and I'm returning the number. I'm returning the number. Where we are considering this number of partitions. I have a small doubt, guys. Please. Okay. I'm using number of partitions here. Let's see. No problem. Let's see. We'll do an experiment. This is my class. I have already. Okay, let me import this again. I have imported. Let me declare my class. I have defined and declared Robin. Not found type partitioner. I just imported, no? What is the problem? What is the problem? Why? Not found type partitioner. Let me do one thing. Opposite dot opposite dot spark dot partitioner only, no? Then what else? Why it is coming like this? So I have defined my partitioner. Now let's go back to the here. Here I use, instead of hash partition, I use my partition. It is not recognizing. Okay, no problem. I'll type it. My partitioner, my partitioner. Very good. My I'm doing a reduce by key. I'm doing a reduce by key. Let me do save as text file. Let me do 20th this time. But my question is, I'm passing only three partitions. I just want to check how it will. Yes. Array index out of bound exception. Because I'm passing only three partitions, but I required more. The 19 came. Four came. Yeah, good. So I need to pass 26. I need to pass 26 here. Okay, then I can do this. Good. Now let's go ahead and do save. Why again it's failing? String index out of bound exception. String out of range, zero. Line number 14. We have taken 0 to 25 only, right? Then why it is 0? String out of range. String out of one exception. Is okay. I don't see. Is there any empty? Okay, let me do one thing. I'll put a condition here. I'll put a condition and the temporary string. If string length greater than zero, then only do this operation. If temporary string, 1 second, let me do it. Null not equal to this, and temporary string dot is empty. It's not empty. It is not null and not empty. Then do this operation. Else return 0. Else return 0. Maybe I'm just what I'm suspecting. There are some empty strings. There are some empty strings. In empty strings, if you try to do the character of 0, you will obviously get an exception. If you have an empty string and if you're doing dot character 0 in empty string, obviously we'll get a string out of range exception only. That's the reason I changed it. My partition already this. I'm trying to do 22. Let's see, this time it should be go good. Good, it went good. Yeah, that was the reason, guys. Because in the words, let me show you here in the output. There is a possibility of empty strings. Look at here, this is empty. Wherever we have empty. This is empty. Wherever you have empty, right? So in empty string, if you do the dot character of 0, it obviously throws an exception. Okay, go to the 22, word count 22. Okay, can anyone guess how many partitions will be created? Part files.
26.
Yes. Okay, I'm just going to see the first one. You see here, all started with A and a special character because we have written 0, right? You guys remember? If in the 0th partition, what we are doing? Not only those things, and we are putting any special character comes. Not only A, any special character comes, we are putting into first partition. That's the reason. Otherwise, you can do another way. You take 27 partitions, keep your special characters in the 27. That's also possible. Okay, but I have put it into same A partition only. Let's go to next partition. It should contain all B's. Only B. This is no matter whether small case or capital case, capital letters or small letters. The reason behind it, we are converting into lowercase here. Everything we are converting into lowercase. Okay, for the calculation purpose. For the calculation purpose, we are converting into lowercase and putting it. So no matter whether it's a small b or capital B, it will go into the same partition. Okay. I'm just removing them because I don't want to keep them. It's unnecessary to eat up the memory. I'm putting the partition 002, which is nothing but the third partition, which will contain the C. You guys understand the now the purpose of the partitioner? Let me go to the 25th one. There are no words start with a Z. There are no words start with a Z. Let's see 25, sorry, 24. In this case, 24. Any words start with Y? Only two. Or 23. There are no 23 means with the, there are no words we start with the X. Are you guys following me? Any doubts so far? It's a simple program, partition algorithm. It's a custom partition. Earlier, what we have seen, it's in a predefined partition which is called hash partition algorithm. So when you do the hash partition algorithm, we really didn't see the much difference with the default and when we use a hash partition. But when we use our own partition algorithm, and also it totally depends how your get partition program you have written. So when you write your get partition program, you should make sure that those many partitions will be passed. If you are not passing those many partitions, obviously you'll end up with the array index out of bound exception because you are returning it. No, I'm returning 26. I mean, here you see I, you're returning that number, right? If that number is not available, it will be through an exception. Any doubts? Similarly, you have something called range partition, guys. Range. In the last session, we have seen based on the range, it will be divided into partition, like a hash partition and the range partition. Okay. You can also use the range partition. You can also use the range partition. So, can I show the range partition example, or you guys can do it your own? I will show you the range partition. So, closely observe. Your range partition takes a number of partitions and RDD as input parameters. Your range partition takes number of partitions and RDD as an arguments. Okay, let me show you that also. I'll try to show you the default one. Here, what you need to do, let's use up arrow. Yeah, here instead of my partition, we need to import it actually, otherwise it will not come. Anyway, let me try new range partition. If it is available, when you press tab, automatically it will come. If it is not coming, means it's not available. Range partitioner actually it is. I'll take four partitions, comma, my RDD I need to pass, which is RDD3, which is RDD3. So RDD3, right? RDD3. Okay, let me see. But it will throw an exception. I'm very much sure about it. The reason behind it, we need to know import org.apache.spark.rang range partition. We're seeing the range dependency. Let's do partitioner, then do import. Partitioner dot why it is not coming range partitioner. Okay, it's taken. Now execute your range partition algorithm. Now you do the reduce by is already applied. Now do the save. Not save your reduce by key. Now do the save. This time I'll specify here explicitly range. Range 22. Go here. Go here. Range 22. So we defined four partitions. We got the four partitions here. Let's open this one. Okay. I think 1 second, 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. These are all based on the range it is divided. Okay. So I don't think I cannot make out the difference how it is, because it's a word range it is divided. These are all in a different characters, started with the different characters. Look at here. So W, S, V, U, Y, R, T. Most of them those characters only. Okay. And if you go and see partition two, it will not be repeated. Whatever there in the these words, like started with the W, T, S, right? R, S, T, U, V, W, I think it is. R is there? Yeah, R, S, T, U, with U, I think there is no words. V, yeah, with V, U, yeah. It started from R, R, S, T, U, V, all comes into last partition. And before that, till R, it is there here. In this R also there. Maybe it falls under this. This R also there, but there is no S, T, so those are not there because it's divided into range. Divided into range. Next one. Here you see. Here we have a D, F, B. And what else is there in the zero? Zero it has. And then why it has? Okay, maybe it's capital letter. Okay, small letter, capital letter. It divided like that. Yeah, got it. This is how the range partition works. So based on the range on the keys, it is split the data. Now here I want to show you how when you do the by key operation, not only reduce by key, any by key operation if you perform, how internally the partitioner help to divide the data. That's what we need to understand. So if it is a hash partition, based on the hash code. If it's a range partition, based on the range. If it is my custom partition, it's based on the whatever the custom partition algorithm you have provided. Whatever the custom partition algorithm you have provided, based on that, it will be used. Is this clear? Any questions?
So what is the advantage we are getting here by specifying a partitioner class and all? So is there any performance improvement or?
No, by default, any of one partition should be there. Without having a partitioner, the data will not be splitted, that the keys will not be distributed. What is the default partitioner? A hash partitioner only. The default partitioner is a hash partitioner. Instead of the default partitioner, you are dividing your own way. Understand, ma? There is no performance and all, it not comes under the picture.
Okay, once go to Spark Shell.
Okay.
So here when you print, I thought this is a print statement. Okay, so just can you scroll? Okay. So here console 34 is there, right? I'm not able to see the line number.
Console 34, yeah. Okay.
Mm-hmm. So here what is shuffle RDD of 20 and here map partitions of 21, what is that number?
Those numbers in the same console when you perform these operations, right? So you can see above there will be some more numbers.
Yeah.
16, 15. Mm-hmm. Same operations only, no? But in this console, when you go, if you go ahead and see here in the shell, you'll understand.
Here also I saw
these numbers.
Shuffle RDD of 4.
Yeah, these numbers only actually. Suppose this is the one second, let me refresh. Okay, so this is the range partition we applied, and this is the recent save as text file. When you click on this, come down.
No, once click on reduce by key in the stages, go to save as text file in the DAG. Yeah. Save as text file. So click on reduce by key operation. So here
the operation
in the
sequence numbers, ma, nothing else. 20, 21, 22. Oh. The sequence numbers, nothing else.
Oh, okay.
What
okay.
How many operations you perform? How many transformations you perform?
Okay. So here in the program,
something is different. I'll come back on this. I'm not also not really sure, but I'm thinking it's a sequence number which the transformation you have applied. This means 22 internal, including internally how it plan, including everything. The sequence number it is coming.
Okay. So once go to hash partitioner program.
Which we have written this one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So here we are just returning the integer number, right? So based on this, how it is arranging all the A's into partition 0 and the B's into partition 1, that thing I did not understand.
It's very simple, right? When you call this method, what will happen? Internally, it will call get partition, correct?
Mm-hmm.
When it's dividing the data, internally, it calls get partition method. What this method is returning?
Just an integer value, right?
It's returning an integer value. So based on that integer value, it decides which partition, which part. See, I'm passing 26 here, correct?
Mm-hmm.
In this 26, 0 to 25 will be there. In this 0 to 25, let's say the word comes, Suma came.
Okay.
So in the Suma, yes, which partition it has to fall? The S word,
okay.
Let's say the starting word is S, right? When you do character of 0, the starting word is S. So the S has to fall on which number in out of 0 to 25, which number it has to fall?
Okay.
That's decided by that number.
Okay.
And it means when you use your my partition of 25, my partition of 25, this is successful only, right? Yeah. My partition of 26 here. So when you do the reduce by key operation, internally it also look for the, which key has to fall under which partition, right? That time it will call get partition, then it will give the number for that specific key. It has to go to this number. Let's take 24, 23, 22, whatever the number it is.
Okay,
that's how internal it get calls.
Okay,
to make you simple understanding, I can put like this. Now you have a key values, correct? Key comma value is there. Now I have a 26 reducers. Let's assume that 26 reducers are there, like and so on. 26 reducers, not actually reducers. They are assume that 0 to 25. You take my, otherwise we'll get another confusion. 0 to 25 buckets are there. Buckets. Okay. Let's assume that they are tasks. Okay. Now I got word called Veera. Value, forget about it, 1, 1, something it came. The value came Suma. Okay, then value, there's some value. Now, as per our algorithm, we are taking the key and extracting the first word, correct?
Yeah.
Now, this first word, when I extract and find it, let's say V falls under 23 or 24. Okay?
Okay.
Or 23. So now, this V, this that algorithm, whatever the my partition algorithm we have written, that decides this V has to go to 23 task. I mean 23 partition. Ideally it's a partition. So S has to fall under 22 or 21. It decides which task it has to go, which partition it has to go. Ideally, which partition it has to go.
Okay.
Clear?
Yeah.
Any other questions?
So here, based on the number of partitions, we are getting multiple files, right?
Obviously.
When we are writing it as save as text file.
Correct. Those many part files will come.
Yeah. So what if I want to read all these files together and create one more RDD? How I can read all this as one file?
You can use the whole text file, or with the text file also, you can just give a this path.
Path. Okay. Okay. So suppose if simply we are writing it in like just normal text file, right? What if it's in like Parquet format or some other format? How we can do? It's the same way.
See, when you talk about the Parquet, Avro, JSON, ORC, they are structure or not semi-structure or unstructured?
JSON is semi-structured.
Okay. Parquet, ORC, Avro.
Oh, I think they are not. They are unstructured because they are not human readable.
They are structured. No. We should not consider if the file is not human readable. We will not consider it unstructured. No, that's wrong assumption. How we will define our data is a structure or unstructured? If my data is properly defined, segregated. It has a delimiter. It has a schema. If you take an example of the Parquet, it has a schema. Internally, it has a schema because the data stores in the form of columnars, all columns together. It has a schema. It's a structure. If you go with ORC, it has a structure. If you go with Avro, it has a structure and it has a schema. If you go with the JSON, even JSON also, it's ideally semi-structure, but with respect to Spark, it's a structure. Because it has a key value pair. It has a key value pair. Key is the your thing. After colon, whatever you specify, it's a value. It's a key value pair. It's also structure for with respect to Spark. So to read all these structures, even CSV, even XML, if you try to read all these structure, you have a different library. That's called spark.read.json, spark.read.parquet, spark.read.format, you can specify the CSV. Okay. So it has its own thing. For others' benefit, or for others, whoever is interested to know all this thing, you guys install your Spark, right? Go to Spark, the home directory, Spark home directory, examples, src main I'm dealing with Scala, Go Scala, Apache, Spark, examples you see here. And this Spark SQL, Spark SQL example, data source example. If you open this, it has, it created a Spark. Look at here, guys. Run basic Parquet example, JSON example, JDBC example. Like that, you have some examples here. Okay. Suppose if you want to load any file or Parquet file, look at this spark.read.load. And suppose if you want to read JSON, spark.read.format.json. Okay. Similarly, Parquet. If you want to save the file as a Parquet, okay. I think we didn't discuss about this file formats. We'll discuss about it, okay. And if you want to run Parquet, if you want to read Parquet, we're reading the JSON file and saving it as a Parquet file. Then again, we'll read somewhere it as a Parquet. Somewhere we'll read it as a Parquet. Sorry, it's writing only, no? Somewhere we'll read it as a Parquet. And these examples are there. You really no need to go here or there and find these things. You have your own examples already defined in the your the Spark installation directory for the different sources. Okay, ma?
Okay, okay. Thank you.
So, yeah. And other one is, these are all SQL operations. We'll talk about it. We'll talk about these things later. What is this RDD relation? Converting RDD to data frame, it looks. Converting RDD to data frame, but anyway, I'll show that. Fine. Still, core is still a lot more. We have to discuss a lot of things like a sort by key, join, unions, intersection, Cartesian. They're all we need to discuss. We'll discuss about them as well. Okay, it takes some time. Okay, so let me close all of them. Any questions with respect to partitioner? Any questions? Okay, if no questions, that's it for today. So we'll connect in the next session. See, when you're writing your own partition, no need to give you the same algorithm. You can write your own algorithm. This is my algorithm because I want to all A's has to be in one partition, all B's has to be in another partition like that. You can go ahead and write your own. Okay, so you can write your own way of. Suppose if you are getting employee data, all males in separately, all females separately, or if you're getting some other department wise you want to write. Suppose you are getting the 10 departments and you want to department wise you want to do a partition. So you can take the department wise, but make sure that the key comes as a department. You have to make sure that the key is the department. Okay, based on the key only, it'll partitions will be divided. Yeah. Go ahead. Someone is asking.
Can you hear me, Mary? Yeah.
Yeah, I'm able to hear you. Yeah.
Just like here in the partition, we stored as a 26-part file.
Okay.
Yeah. So in the output session, it came as a 26-part /00/001. So can we modify this output file name as well?
Sorry. Okay. Part as 00. I lost the last part. You're asking something this, I think. A part as 00?
Yes,
I didn't
yes.
get you.
So over here, like it will be, can we, before loading it, can we rename it like part A, like A and then 000, like it will be having the A related data. It
that
will be
can
having.
Be done, Ma. Yes, that can be done. I think I did it in MapReduce. In Spark, I didn't try that because there is no use with it, but in MapReduce I did it. where we can write our custom name, custom output file name. It's called custom output file name. Let me show that. I'm not really sure whether the example is there here or not. You can check. One second. It comes with the file format. Custom input file format it is. Combine input file format. In output format it is. We will write our custom names. We will define for our own names. That can be, that is possible with the MapReduce. I'm not really sure with the Spark. I'll check today. I'll revert on this.
Okay, sure.
And one more thing. Yeah, it is possible. I have seen it. Yeah, it is possible. But we have to do a little tweak. What we need to do before it write into the disk, what we need to do, we need to read this that path. We need to rename it. Yeah, I did it in one of the Spark example also. I forgot that algorithm. I have that example. I'll show you, ma. I have that example. That's correct. I did it on time. Okay, so that's it for today. I think it's took time more time. Any questions? Any other questions? Okay, if no questions, we can leave for the day. We'll connect in the next session. We'll discuss in detail.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.